Hey guys, welcome to Gardening Upbeat, and I hope you are doing very well. It feels great whenever we can grow some veggies for ourselves, but not all have access to good soil, and without good soil it's too difficult to grow tasty vegetables. This is why I have decided to do one video showing how you can grow any leafy vegetables in only sand. That's right, only sand is needed, and there is no need to work hard looking for good soil. On this video, I am going to show you how to grow methi or fenugreek only in sand. Please follow the complete procedures so that you can grow them in sand or even in very poor soil which doesn't contain any nutrients at all. These are the seeds that I have collected from local store. You can also buy online, but online they are usually a bit costly. For the pot, going to use this pot which is around 6 inch wider and 6 inch deeper. Fenugreek grows to about 60 cm high and forms a deep reaching taproot. So please don't use pot where depth is less than 6 inches. More depth is ideal if you can manage. Here I am filling the pot with sand, as you can see. Sowing the seeds now, and the ideal temperature to grow the fenugreek is around 10 to 32 degrees Celsius. Please don't get worried by looking at the small brown or black particles in the sand. The sand was there under one of my big tree, and those are just part of drying stems, leaves, etc. After sowing the seeds, covering them with sand. Please note, they should be planted at least 5 to 8 mm deep. Many gardeners also soak the seeds overnight to germinate them faster. Not required, as they germinate quite fast even without doing that. But of course you can do that if you like. I have just covered them with a cloth, as the sparrows trouble me a lot here and there. Again, this is not a mandatory step. They are starting to germinate, and as you can see, sand is also looking dry. So at this stage, I used to spray water as soon as I saw that the sand is dry. Please note, at this time they were getting whole day of sunlight. This is an update after 15 days. Looking good, but at this time we must apply nutrients, or else they would turn yellow, as sand doesn't contain any nutrients. Please note, if we don't provide them any nutrients, they would just taste like grass. Believe me, I have tried this before. I usually use one product from Amazon. The name of the product is Green Loop Hydroponic Nutrients, and they have two products, one for leafy vegetables and another for fruiting vegetables. Please note, I am not at all promoting any products here. I am only sharing as I use them myself. Though it's a hydroponic nutrients, this works well whenever we grow anything in sand. Here is how to use them. Please follow the steps. Step number 1. Take the A component and mix it with 1 liter water. Step number 2. Similar way, take the B component and mix it with 1 liter water. We can store them separately, and they can be used for next 5 to 6 months. Then whenever we need to make the liquid nutrients, we need to do the below steps. Step number 1. Take 1 liter water. Step number 2. To make strong dose, take 10 ml from the first one and 10 ml from the second one. Step number 3. For lighter dose, please take only 5 ml from each bottles. Now we can apply them as nutrients. Because of sand, the water would drain out very fast and nutrients would get wasted. This is why I am using a tray here. I would let it stay as it is for next 20 to 30 minutes. Please also note, right now I am using only 1/2 liter water, as it's more than enough for such pot. This is after 20 minutes, and as you can see that the sand has already absorbed almost all the water with nutrients. This is only after 22 days. As I have applied the nutrients, they are growing really well and they are ready for harvesting. Looking so healthy, are not they? We can harvest them two ways. First method, just pull the whole plant and then cut the lower part. We can do this as there are plenty of them, and after doing this, others are going to get more space to grow. Second method, cut the upper part like this and let them regrow again. So far, I have applied the nutrients only once. Applying once in 10 to 12 days would be sufficient. In case you don't want to use the same nutrients, then please check out the next video about growing mints in water. It's also an easy process. Hope you found this video useful, and if you did, I would really appreciate if you give it a like, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel if you are new to Gardening Upbeat. Thank you so much for watching. Take care and enjoy.